So thank you all for volunteering to serve on this committee as they try to figure out what, because they probably, even before those plans were already drafted, been trying to figure out for quite a long time what we're gonna do, where we're gonna have their offices. We had a strategic planning session where a few options sort of bubbled to the top. And correct me if I'm wrong, please, someone, I believe they were Silver Street, that where the old highway barn is, the Turcot Field, which is off of Scoutland Road, back in the woods, and...
Rollins Road.
Oh, Rollins, thank you. The property on Rollins Road that is currently for sale, and is still for sale. The sign told me this afternoon when I drove home. So with that, I know the chief has prepared some documents. He's been doing some work ahead of time, which is a good thing. The documents and contractors, so if you want to present what you have for now.
Okay.
And then,
Can I just ask one question? Are we talking strictly police? Are we talking town hall and police?
Well, at the moment, we're just talking police, but as part of this conversation, it seems like it's most prudent that we should be doing it combined with the resources that we have, then we can,
spare.
I suppose.
We can,
There you go.
Thank you. I don't want to preclude the conversation, but, really, we're just supposed to be focused on police things. But if it makes sense, if there are viable options to combine, I think we should probably present that in the select board at the same time.
Okay, thank you.
What I've given you is a floor plan and for new facility. And it's almost a square foot for the same space that we have downstairs. I think this one here is 2 or 3 feet wider. The only addition is at the top of the page, you see the addition of a 4-bay garage at the back of the building. So what I've done is I've taken our current floor plan and moved things around. And again, this isn't set in stone. This is just to give us some place to start with when we talk to contractors and whatnot. Because some things may have to move it depending on builders' needs and building regulations or whatever the case might be. But I've kept the three elements separate. I've kept the public away from the working part of the building. I kept the working part of the building away from the public part of the building and the booking, detention, the bad people area. So. Sallyport is the garage that you drive into
okay.
with your prison road.
Oh, okay.
That's what Sallyport is.
Okay.
Straightforward. So this would meet current compliance standards?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. No, detention. That's the jail.
That's our what we call a temporary detention room. Right. That's a secure room where we hold folks for no longer than 2 hours while they're waiting to get posted for bail or waiting to transport them to court or something like that.
So there is no so called jails?
No, there's no jail cell.
And is that normal?
Yeah.
For a PD not to have a jail cell?
Well, some departments don't even have a temporary detention room. We actually have one downstairs.
Mm-hmm.
And rather than leave someone hooked up to, handcuffed to the bar on the wall, we'll put them in the room, shut the door, then they have access to a bench where they can sit down or lay down if they want to, and they have access to a toilet and sink if they need to use it. This way, the officer doesn't have to stay in the booking room and monitor them. He can go and do what he needs to do in another room as long as he's watching the monitor to watch the individual in the temporary detention.
That's not they go to the county, right?
Correct.
You don't.
Right. Violent people go, if we arrest someone on the street and they're violent, they go right straight to county. We don't process them here.
Oh.
And if we arrest more than 3 individuals at the same time, they go to county and we process up there. We don't process them here.
Okay.
But we have had occasions where we've had 2 people arrested at the same time. So while the officer is in the booking room with one, the other person is waiting in the detention room, and we just swap them back. But every single room that you see here is a room that we currently have downstairs with the addition of a public bathroom. If you go into the lobby, go up the hallway on the right-hand side, you'll see there's a public bathroom right there. But every other room that you see on here, we currently have downstairs.
So the male locker, the female locker, it's also a bathroom facility as well?
Correct.
It's not locker room?
Right, you're still,
okay.
Yeah, it's a bathroom facility for the females and a bathroom facility for the males.
It certainly looked, the only thing that hits me right away is if the sally port should be close or incorporated in the four-bay garage. And I don't know what your thoughts are on that, or if it would make more sense to put that in the back also and just move a couple rooms around or something. But again, it's so, you know, that's the only thing that strikes me. And I don't know, just off the top of my head. Other than that, I mean, it certainly seems like you got everything covered here and the community room. And then, again, to Denise's point, I think if we did go with some sort of a town hall, and put that over on this side, share the community room, as long as, and I imagine you have some sort of, you would have some sort of secure...
Right, there'd be secure doors in the hall.
The doors between the two, but correct. I mean, it's right next to that, and that might, you know, be a good fit. Again, that's my only thought is, you know, to put the sally port in the back, so the prisoners come in the back and, you know, just flop some things around. But I don't know. That's,
well, the reason I did that, because if we use it, the four-bay garage as a sally port as well, I mean, we're talking about, well, we have equipment stored in there and whatnot. If a prisoner managed to break loose and try to escape or whatever, there may be implements at his disposal there. The sally port, there should be nothing in there other than maybe an eyewash station.
Right.
So if for some reason they do break loose from the officer, they can't do anything. They can't grab hold of anything. That's the reason we did that.
I don't see any storage on here. I'm assuming your bay garages are not going to be storage, like paperwork storage.
Correct.
Where is your storage?
Well, what are we talking about? What kind of storage?
I'm talking about file cabinets for all of your records, unless you...
Central records, bottom right-hand side.
Okay. So this is a big room for the file cabinets?
That's a large room. And actually, each square is approximately a foot.
Okay.
So that central records room is 27 feet long.
Okay.
By 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 feet, roughly.
Okay.
You know, and I say roughly because then you have to account for the width of the walls and things like that. And that's just roughly.
No.
So all of the other stuff, you know, uniforms and equipment, we have room for that. We have a separate room for our firearms and our ammunition. And then everything else that we would have, you know, signs and whatnot will be stored in the, you know, somewhere in the four-bay garage.
Okay. So there isn't a cellar that's going to be put under this. It's going to be strictly a
slab.
Slab.
It'd be a slab and or if we go modular, which I've got some information on, then they want it on a... what's the 4 foot? Frost wall.
But nothing that's going to be able to store something down into a cellar.
Right. No basement.
Or basement.
No cellar basement.
Any overhead storage at all?
No.
But this would be on a 4 foot frost wall anyway.
Correct.
Just because of the size of the building.
Yeah.
The slab.
But again, like I said, this isn't set in stone. This may change as it progresses. So. At least this way here gives us all the rooms that we need, and I think that will take care of us in the future. If the plan is to eventually, you know, put the town hall or the fire department or whatever on the right-hand side, at that point, then I would suggest that we just make the conference room a little bit bigger than what I currently have here. So,
I'm sorry, say that again.
If we do end up deciding that the town hall should be attached to the police department or something, or the fire department, then I would suggest that we make the conference room bigger than what I have here.
So this layout, does it fit on Silver Street?
It does.
With ample parking?
It does.
But not being able to add on
town required, clearly.
The building is, I mean, the land, the size of the lot is not big enough for anything other than one town hall function.
Yep.
The lieutenant, I went out and measured it, and the fence line, from fence line to fence line, it's 777 square feet, front to back, left to right. On either side of the fence, you have probably 20, 25 feet before you get to the neighbor's yard. In the back, there's 50 feet approximately before you get into the big gully. And then from the fence line to Silver Street, there's approximately 20 to 24 feet there. So it's ample enough to have parking in the front, some parking on the side, and then room to get into that if need be.
Also, any of the three locations that you had mentioned are potentially spaces, none of them have sewer, right?
Correct.
So they would have to be on a septic, and that's not an issue.
There's space for a few of these.
Well, it should be one there already on Silver.
Yeah, from what the builders have told me, you can actually put the leach field underneath your parking lot. The only thing they have access to is the pit to drain it. Rollins Road site and Turgeon Lane, well, Turcot Field, I should say, there's no water there. At least here we have a ton of water.
Is that where you'd have to drill for a well?
Correct.
Both of those, you'd have to drill for a well?
The other two.
Okay. Even the one, am I correct, it's the one right after the overpass on the right?
No, that's what we thought.
They don't have water there?
No, you drive into Greenview.
Am I talking on the wrong side? The one that was for sale is the one that abuts what the cows got, right? That doesn't have water there?
I don't think the water extends on the other side.
The lane doesn't have water?
No.
My understanding was it was the other side of the track.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
No, Main Street then, went left, Silver Street, yeah.
And then the refinery doesn't have water?
They might have it from Summersworth.
They could have.
Summersworth right up here? Because there, I don't know, what's that road there down?
Well, I know Summersworth Road, the Argos are on a well, I know that, so, which is behind, the refinery is behind them.
But really, at that point, maybe we could get water from Summersworth.
If it's available.
If it's available, yeah.
Because those houses, that road, when you, right before you get to the turn at the town line, is a road that goes up to the right.
Olden Hill Road.
Yeah.
Those wells.
Those are all wells.
Those are wells, yeah.
Where on Rollins Road is the site? Because there's Dover water, is that, I think it runs up the.
Well, once you go past the overpass, you come off the overpass.
Yep.
And before you get to Pease Lane, that field that's right there on the inside, that's the part that they're talking about.
But the problem is the tracks, go under the tracks or whatever to get water there if you needed to.
Yeah.
Yeah. Plus, we're handling the top.
But the distance from this lot line back to the Caris, you could run a sewer line.
We've talked about that.
I actually spoke with the folks at the water department, and because of that big gully down there, you're talking extraordinary expense to get the water, the sewer pipe to come up, go down, and come back up. Because it's a very deep gully back there. They said it's probably cost prohibitive.
We don't need that cost.
Any other questions on the layout at this point?
That's good.
The folks that built the new Farmington Police and Fire saw our article in the paper, asked to meet with me, and I met with them, I actually met with them twice now. And actually took a tour of the new station up in Farmington along with Bill, happened to be there for a monthly chief's meeting. Anyway, they took a copy of my plan, and they put together a packet for everybody. And the Farmington building is an ICF building, which is insulated concrete form, which means that they put in the foam insulating blocks, 2.5 inches, 2.5 inches, And then you have 6, 8, or 10-inch wall of cement within your 5 inches total of insulation. So your entire outside wall is all, is completely cement. So it's more fireproof, it's more bullet resistant. It's less susceptible to water damage and mildew and mold and rot and the like. So.
They said, I believe they said it comes in at an R50.
R50.
For the walls.
Yep.
Which is, you know, it's pretty impressive.
It also will help with conserving energy as well. I mean, like you're heating all those.
In the long run, you'll be conserving energy. So soup to nuts. That means they do everything, which also includes design. You're talking, they're estimating $1,107,959.02, or $169 a square foot. And that's everything, soup to nuts. Site work, total installation, demo work. Again, these are just rough numbers. You know, should we decide to at some point to really sit down with them, the numbers can be adjusted. But I just asked, I was just looking for a general number to present to the board, and to the committee at some point, so we have an idea where we're going with this thing. So I don't know what to expect. But they've got some photos in the back of buildings that they recently bought. I don't know if you're familiar with the building down the road from Lowe's in Rochester. The I think it's 4 stories. It's all said and done. That's an ICF building as well. Completely a cement wall. Hurricane proof and all that good stuff.
Did you get into it with them in terms of heating, cooling, or what they were doing? Or probably too early.
Yeah, that's too early. They just gave a rough idea for heating and cooling for all the time.
Yeah, so.
Yeah.
We just saw this the other day, but
they
wasn't part of them.
Yeah, mechanical $69,595. So. Again, these are just rough numbers.
Yeah.
Having said that, they actually drew up a set of plans for us to review.
They did seem very enthusiastic.
They did, yes. And again, this is at no cost to Town of Rollins at this point. But they've changed some rooms around on their plan here. But there's the floor plan, and this is what they would anticipate that the front of the building could look like, residential in nature. Front doors, and over here would be the sally port and conference room on this island. And then I'll pass it around, but then they've got the sally port coming off to the side of the building where I had it coming in front.
Yeah.
And the rear of the building. I'll pass this around so you guys take a look at it.
The type of house that Al Leon had built.
Yes.
Same company.
Same company, actually, too, yeah?
Yep.
Yeah.
His own house.
Yeah.
Do you like it?
Oh, he looks good.
Yeah, very energy efficient.
Take two candles, you know.
No, two black bunches.
More than that.
When I spoke to them, you know, they asked, you know, what type of building do you want? Do you want modular or whatever? I said, no, because, you know, my vision has always been to put us on sewer. So I said, we'll have to fit in with the neighborhood. So it has to have a residential look in nature. It can't look like a commercial building. So.
Yes, no, that's
amazing.
If it goes on Silver Street, you'll be staring at it for many years.
While that's going around, I also spoke with Tom Noonan, Middle Plain Lumber, because he designed houses. And they actually have two companies. One company, Milton Lumber, they don't do modules, but they do, what do you call them, something with the walls. They'll put the wall together and then ship it to your site and then put all the walls up separately. Well, the module comes in within a big box. They send down prefab. No, it wasn't prefab, it was, anyway, I've got copies of the letter that he sent to me here, and 1, 2, 3. And based upon my drawing, he said that the Middleton Lumber folks, you're looking at a 1.2 to 1.3 million dollar project, and then again, that's everything soup to nuts.
So it's in line with the.
So it's in line with the. Having said that.
But this one being a little more, or that one being a little more on the secure side, and maybe a little more efficient with shipping and stuff, like the concrete.
Correct.
More so than the.
Hurricane comes through, that building will be the only building standing on Silver Street.
Hey, wait a minute.
That's why we're gonna invite you over. We'll invite you over.
Yeah, so for the same money, kind of like.
I like the cement walls.
I think it's first, I think that's the second building.
So I did some research online, and I know that the modular building can be a little less expensive than on-site build. And I've contacted several companies. The first one is Avalon. And based upon the sketch that I sent them, they estimate that a modular building would be around the $350,000 to $400,000 range, but that is set only. That doesn't include everything from soup to nuts. That's just taking the building, putting it on our work that we've done, and then we do the button up for it. But I will make that again, copies of that.
So what you're saying is it's just putting the building in, but then you have to do all of the finishing work inside, is what you mean?
Correct.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
You got a generator in this building, or is that an add-on?
That'd be an add-on. Actually, we can apply for a grant for half that.
Do you have one here?
We do, yes.
Could you take it with you?
Well, I think we keep it here for town hall.
Oh, okay, that's town hall as well.
You know, for the expense of having to disconnect it, move it, reconnect it, I think you'd better serve just to stay here.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that should be your, definitely.
Right.
If not an add-on, but that should be part of it.
Correct. I agree with you.
Put the building up in terms of power people in a disaster.
Right.
So.
I am awaiting, I've been talked with the folks at New England Homes, and they're out of Dover, and I didn't realize they were actually still in business. I thought they went out of business years ago. But they're actually a subsidiary of Middleton Lumber, and they do the module units. You know, they'll come in and drop a box, boom, 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 several boxes. And also, I'm in contact with the folks at KSB, the builders now out of South Paris, Maine. So hopefully at our next meeting, we'll have something more concrete with them folks. I'm hoping to meet with Tom Clark in the next couple of weeks before I meet with the folks in South Paris, just to see, have him look at my plan and say, you know, what type of egress security do we need as far as push bars and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
So,
have you figured furnishings? Or that's going to be an add-on?
That would be an add-on here.
Janitor's desk.
Depending on what we do, there might be some things that we can utilize from downstairs here. At some point, I'll ask Howard to take a look at, like, so maybe some of the counters and maybe the lockers and whatnot, and see if they can be easily removed, and then we might be able to save a little bit of money in the long run there by utilizing them someplace else.
Mm-hmm.
So,
I'd just still get all this stuff.
It'd be nice.
What about security cameras and all of that? Is that also an add-on?
That will also be an add-on.
So what we're talking about there is strictly the building.
Right, the building.
But it's finished rooms and everything. Everything's finished, but anything above that is going to be addition.
Would be addition to it. Talking furnishing, security, video, telephone, and generator. Generator and security, we can probably get a matching grant for Homeland Security. and/or Homeland Security, because this will be, this will be our new emergency operations center.
Yeah.
And they love to.
Yep.
Give you money when you're doing emergency operations center.
Yes, exactly.
So.
Do we know if we can bring three-phase power in on the street there, what that run looks like, or are we gonna deal with that issue?
Can you tell me what three-phase power is?
As I understand it, it's each leg of power is offset by, I don't know, 90, not 90 degrees, but it provides more efficient power.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't fully understand it, but it's easier for motors and large equipment to run on three-phase power than it is for what's generally called single-phase, which is what utilities have, I mean, most residents have.
Residents have.
I know enough to get in trouble.
Well, I know the school is having that, or has just put that in or something, but I thought it was because of the volume of, I mean, you wouldn't have the volume that they have, as in computers.
Well, we have three-phase power here for this one.
Oh, you do?
So I don't know if it's something they do with the pole, or something, but.
But that's what that big box is now on the side off of Willie Street, right, isn't that the?
It might be a transformer there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Really, we need like.
Can you talk to Dennis Burke?
Yeah.
He would be able to explain that to you.
He would be able to explain it.
Because I think he did, actually did the work.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm actually meeting with him shortly to discuss our repeater issue on top of the hill at the power, so I can ask him about that.
Oh, see if that would be highly recommended to do.
Because it is not gonna increase the cost, we would have to look at it right now. I'm assuming we would need it for the building, at least that's what I sort of heard with the schools and so forth, we would need it, although I suppose the electrical department should need that.
I don't think so.
Sort of all those places.
There's not much more in this building besides, I mean, there's not a lot going on, you know, equipment-wise upstairs.
Right.
But they have it here, so it's gotta be a reason why.
I mean, you wouldn't even have a lift over there, you would need that, so maybe you don't.
Maybe not, yeah.
So that brings us back to Silver Street property.
Right.
So, I know that the town just recently, I think, hired a company to go and look for hazardous material in the ground or whatever ground. But as part of that, they did not survey the property, so you know exactly where the property lines are. I spoke with Paul Conley from Silver Consultants, and he said, yeah, we bought $3,500 to come in and survey that for you. The town has used Cardigan Mountain in the past for surveying projects, and his was $2,350. So I think in any event, whether the police department goes there or if the town decides they're gonna sell it at some point, it'd probably be beneficial for us to know exactly where the property lines are.
Mm-hmm.
Having said that, I would hope that Kenny would recommend to the select board to maybe hire Cardigan Mountain to go in and properly survey that as soon as possible.
Mm-hmm.
If the town can find it in their budget to do that, I can absorb it in the police budget. So.
What are you giving up?
What's that?
What would you have to give up to do that?
Well, our patrolman number four, we had money in his line item, because he did not start in May.
Okay.
He's actually starting in August.
Okay.
So there's some money there.
Okay.
So.
I think we definitely should do that for sure. I'd like to see the amount of town versus police, but.
Speaking of the Silver Street property, I know, you know, the discussion, maybe a land swap or sell some property or buy a piece of property, whatever. You know, my goal is to try to make this as less expensive to the town folks as possible in the long run. And, you know, the Silver Street property, there may or may not be hazardous stuff there. If you decide to sell it as residential, is the town going to be required to clean that up a little bit? I don't know. Whereas if you put us there, then you don't have to haul all that crap out of there, or, you know, I don't know.
I would think it would be the town's responsibility if you sold it.
The folks that have been doing the brownfield study, from the tests they've done so far, they believe it's just surface oil, you know, stuff like that.
Minimal.
Yeah. Real heavy duty contamination back there.
Mm-hmm.
Was oil probably when their clean trucks just sort of dumped at one time?
Mm-hmm.
Unlikely. And,
well, there's a train in that garage.
So it went somewhere, right? So, but you know, they weren't very, you know,
They're all there, although.
Yeah.
So we should be okay there. Yeah, no, there could be mitigation steps that might be taken for this, so I don't know for sure, but there's a possibility. So the other two options are, well, I guess there's a third one too that would be any problem because I wouldn't say. Turco field, which also then includes laying out a road. One way or other, from one side or the other, either the, on the Summersworth end, up at Golden or Low Hill, down through, that's the tail end, that's not the tail end, Skeleton, is it?
The other one would be the tail end of Greenview.
Greenview.
Either going for Greenview or come in from Old Indigo Hill Road.
Right. I just said that railroad bed there, so I was thinking, so probably along that. Can't wait to get the call from those folks on the board.
I think at that point you're talking, you know, probably millions of dollars just to do the.
To lay out a road, right. I don't disagree with you, but.
And the fact that, you know, you're out there in the middle of nowhere.
Right.
So.
The only advantage that that property has is that there's enough room to build additional town hall facility if that's what people want to do. I would argue that one, you're in the middle of the woods, I think you'd want to be visible. And two, it's going to cost a small fortune to lay out a road, I would say. To me, it's not really a viable option, but I'm sure one that folks seem interested in. But to be honest, I think people were more interested at that meeting when they thought Turco Field was actually the Wentworth Field at the.
Right.
At the bottom there.
At the cornfield, yeah.
You know, the people just assume all that's where the corn is planted, that's what they assume, because we rent that out.
I just did. Where is it?
Oh, it's way, no, it's way out in the.
You mean, like, behind everyone's house on Summersworth?
Yes. Oh, yeah. Way back, and not even.
We go there, I'm sorry, I thought you were talking about that big field where the corn was grown.
I thought it was.
You go.
I thought that originally.
Oh, I think that's off the table.
To Mark Tucher's farm.
Yeah, yeah.
And went to the very back of his property and then walked to the woods some more, you come to another field, and that would be.
That's out.
Part of it.
At least you could, at least you were visible in that big cornfield.
You know, and people said, well, you could do a land swap, but for that property, for something else, but I don't. You're going to get stuck with the roof one way or another.
We own that?
Yeah, it's conservation land that we rent out to be able to.
That's why I asked, the train would be an issue because I think it was overweight in front of the.
Right.
By the tracks.
And so the other option then is off of Rollins and Pease, that corner of that lot, which is what, a little over 3 acres? Like what the sign said.
It's pretty wet there too.
Yeah.
All the standing water there. We already got a.
We already have a water. Howard, I think, it didn't need much convincing, but I think that.
Solar Street is a really good one, but.
Well, I think Solar Street is the right direction as well, but my only concern is that this is a big building for half a dozen people, heat-wise and all of that, you know. So I'd like to see a complex, but I don't think it's going to be.
I get that. There are options that could be done with this building though also, if you were in a stay. We talked about insulating the upstairs. I mean, there are some folks that have grandiose plans. They think the building's going to be somehow restored. It would be nice, but it's not going to happen, let's be honest. We're going to redo the upstairs and we're going to reopen. It's going to be, I don't know what, but we're going to have a theater again up there or whatever. It's not a realistic option. So if you could insulate that floor, we've had some folks come in and take a look at it. It did analysis for free. Insulate the walls here, and I don't know, then maybe it's a little more viable option for the people that are here for that. It's a limited amount of time, doesn't make sense, but I'm just throwing ideas out. I'm not saying this is what's going to happen. Doesn't make sense to build a whole new building for 20 hours a week. I don't know, when you have one here that you could do a little bit more work on. I know no one wants to put any more money into this building, I get that, but it's just an option to think about. I don't think we're going to be building in the town hall, even if we had a larger piece of property. I don't think we're going to right now. Police is really the immediate problem, so. Anyways. And so the other option that people have talked about, which I will be very upfront with you, I don't personally support, but I think it needs to be talked about anyways, is regionalization of the police department. That is, either sharing responsibility with another community, with people in the county, the state police, I don't know, whoever else you would do it with. Maybe those are the only three options, but it's an idea that has been brought forward. It's an idea that the select board has talked about on a couple of occasions. There are merits to it, for sure, and to me, there are a lot more cons than pros to that concept, but I know my good friend here has talked, and I don't know if they're going to the bus, but I've done this, but just in general, a general concept of regionalization makes sense for certain things, but I'm not sure.
I just want to make sure that
we should talk about it.
We talk about it, and, you know, as we look to do this, is that, you know, I think it's something we at least need to look at and say, you know, we looked at it and it's not going to work for us, or it is. You know, the key, I think, here is to contact other agencies, you know, either the sheriff's office or, you know, with Dover or Summersworth. Either take us on or be part of them. That's the only options I see. South Berwick, we can't. I mean, it's another state. The laws are different. We simply can't do that. But it would be those communities and say, look, this is what we're looking at doing. Is that a viable option?
Yeah. There are capacity issues for those departments. And I don't know. I'm just saying, are there capacity issues for those departments already?
Yeah.
Would be adding Rollinsford in?
Well, then I would, you know,
respond to time
hold that. That they would, you know, if that came to be, they would add our staff to their departments and do something along with. I just think it's something that should be at least discussed and say, yeah, we did our due diligence, we looked at it, it's going to work or it's not going to work, and we go forward whichever way.
I don't know, just enough conversations I've had with different people on both sides to kind of know what I'm talking about, but I don't. I'm very upfront. And from what I've heard, at first blush, don't like the idea. I like the idea of having our own police department, much like I like the idea of having our own fire department, our own school. But I think there are financial constraints to consider. While we're going through this exercise, it's a perfect time, I think, to do it. Because if we're looking at another, at least at 1.1, 1.2, just to build the building, move that, outfit it, I think we should do our due diligence and at least look at this issue.
And that's really all I'm, you know.
And I've already said up front that it's not a concept I really like, but I think we'd be doing a disservice to the community if we didn't at least look at it, so.
Any additional costs on this would be building the parking lot, too.
In the parking lot, right.
Both Groen and Middleton Lumber, so supermarkets, everything.
Yeah, but the Groen.
Groen
already served with more. Groen, I don't know, almost a decade, I think I'm going to say his name now. I still can't say his name, but.
How many parking spaces would they?
Groen.
I don't think it's that specific.
The one on Silver Street, is it, you going to be able to go completely around the building? Or no? So what do you?
I would envision maybe a row of parking in the front, a row of parking on the side, and then access to the back garages. Except not all the way around the building.
So it's not going to, you're not going to be able to go around the building?
No.
Okay.
I was thinking of snow. Making it easy for the guys to plow, they can push all the snow straight back.
Yeah.
And in the back, they can push it all this way.
Yeah.
And that leaves everything open.
It's going to be added security concerns too, right? We're going to grab a car all the way around.
Most folks wouldn't be, you wouldn't think would be going in the back of the building anyway.
So your parking for your officers would probably be in the rear, and your parking in the front would be where people need to go in.
Parking in the front side would be
in.
For the visitors, yes.
Yeah.
But thinking back to Silver Street property, I have spoken with the folks who live on the left side of the building and the right-hand side of the building, and they have no objections. However, having said that, I think that we should come up with maybe a quick survey that we can send out to people saying, you know, if the town appropriated the money to put a police station in this spot, would you be in favor of that? Yes or no? And maybe send it to, you know, all the folks who live a half a mile in either direction and, you know, maybe down Silver Lane. And send it, so you return anonymously or if you want to put their name on it, obviously. And, you know, so I think that, then we'll have an idea, you know, if the neighbors really want to have that down there. But, you know, they might say to our face, yeah, I love that idea, but, you know.
Sure.
Yeah.
And I look, well, you know, well, please, the next door, no, I don't know, he's a wife and I fight and all that.
I was gonna say, there are a couple of residents around there that.
But, yeah, but there are a couple on the street that could use some extra police attention, right?
It's not the noise.
No, I would say not, not where you or your immediate neighbor, maybe catty corner, not you.
And traffic should not be a big issue, you should not have a lot of traffic.
It's already.
It's already a busy road anyway, so it wouldn't.
Not, not, yeah.
I think the idea that it's highly visible to it is important, right?
Yeah.
Right of that.
And now that, that location actually a little more centrally located to the entire town.
Right.
As opposed to being stuck down there.
Yeah, yeah. And anything on Jesse Road is, that there's nothing there as well? Is it Jesse Doe?
Jesse Doe.
I'm sorry, Jesse Doe.
We.
Not really.
Not really.
Yeah, I didn't think so either, I just was bringing.
At one time, there was talk about putting us up on top of the hill, Water Street.
Oh, okay.
When the town took over the old Redmond Building.
Yeah.
And, you know, at that time, I was kind of against it because you got the railroad tracks right there. If something happens right there and or if it takes up part of the bridge, we're stuck over there, we're ineffective, we can't do anything.
Yep.
So.
That's true, that's true.
All right, it says 10,000 square feet of parking.
I would be more than happy to offer my volunteers to, if we want to come up with some quick verbiage to send out on the survey, they can research the who to send, send the letters to, send them all, we'll return an envelope and hopefully have them here for our next meeting.
Yeah.
So.
What do we need to decide, or do we need to decide anything, or are we gonna make a call and say, you know, Silver Street is what we want?
Well, I think that what the chief was suggesting was that this group should suggest to the select board, recommend to the select board, that Silver Street lot gets surveyed.
Okay.
One way or another, whether we actually build there.
Yeah.
Or we sell it.
Yeah.
It needs to be, you know, we sell it to raise money to build somewhere else, so purchase another piece of property, it needs to be surveyed.
Sure.
So, that seems to make sense to me, too. We use, we don't exclusively use Cardigan Mountain, they've just been the most reasonable.
Really?
And they're way the heck up, Cardigan Mountain, which is way the heck up, Rafton County, Sullivan County area, way away from us. And
Orange, New Hampshire, wherever that is.
Orange.
Right, heard of it.
Alexandria, Bristol.
Kachiko.
So they're far away, but they're most responsive in the chief, actually, of all the surveying companies we've tried to use in the past several years. So I think it would make sense for us to make that recommendation. I'll be happy to bring that forward on Monday evening. So they know that it will be beneficial. I think also for us, it would be beneficial to go out and look at the sites, both Silver. We take a look at Rollins, it's on our property, but we can look at it from the road, I guess. I think Howard Jeffs, right, I think it's very wet.
Well, it's also, you have to buy it.
And we have to buy it.
And the other one.
And we need to go and look at.
Yeah, look at Turcot doing.
Well, we, you know what, we don't have to get out, but people should be aware. There are a couple of other members that aren't here. I know Kim had shown some interest at that strategic planning session that we had, listing site, whatever we call it. So she might want to see it.
Yeah.
To see, you know, either yes, she still thinks it has merit, or no, it doesn't. I mean, so it would make sense to go out and take a look at these properties.
Yeah.
And we need to walk the Silver Street one for sure, I think.
But again, you have to buy that.
What?
Turcot property.
No, we own.
Oh, we own that.
We own.
Oh, I'm sorry.
We own Silver and Turcot.
The issue that we would have would be laying on a road.
Well, and also it's in the woods. That's kind of an issue.
There's no argument for me. But there are associated costs, just because we own it. There are associated costs with all three options.
Okay.
That would, to me, would be a pretty expensive option. And we, do we see any benefit? I mean, probably not that anyone talked about, Chief, but do we see benefit maybe taking a look downstairs real quick? Just to see what we have, because the other thing we didn't really talk about, and to me it's not a viable option, but we should also mention it, we could rehab downstairs. I think we all probably share that. But if folks think there are merit, some merit, at least going down, looking at the layout downstairs, seeing what they have at the moment, maybe with this map in hand, trying to, you know, picture, seeing what the, I don't want to call it the mess, but I think you've done an amazing job with the resources you have. The design downstairs to make some of the flaws. But if you don't see merit in it this evening, we don't have to do it.
I mean, personally, I just don't think it's good to put anybody in the basement.
I don't disagree with you.
We have nothing but issues down there, and I think we will continue to have nothing but issues. I mean, I'm good.
I've seen the issues downstairs. I know Howard has seen the issues downstairs.
I've seen them.
You've seen them, Jose? We've all seen them, so we don't need to do it.
And you won't see the big pumps of all the cracks, the big cracks in the floor, right? Because that was just.
It just had that week's taken care of.
But could happen again, maybe.
But, well, I think history will tell us, we have an idea of what we're doing.
Probably, yeah, right? But in the meantime, they can still work.
We gotta get out of there.
Yeah.
But potentially, if we do build a new police station somewhere else, downstairs can be used by maybe some other, maybe a business or a small office or something could rent it from the town or something like that. I mean.
I don't know.
Maybe putting.
Storage.
I don't know, storage or, yeah.
I think all it's worth is storage, because I don't think people should be down there.
No, I agree, but.
And so.
We want to be very careful what we store down there too.
Yeah.
I just think that opens up a big liability to the town.
Probably, yeah.
And the $250,000 is what approximately was.
That was just, but that didn't, remember, that didn't include everything you needed to fix down there.
Yeah, no.
That was just for the demo, putting up new floors and putting the walls back up.
Yeah.
So you could be like another $1,000,000.
At least, oh, I think maybe even a little more, because there were, there were a lot of costs that were never disclosed.
If you can put up one for $1,000,001, yeah.
Or even if you went with a module.
Right.
Yeah.
It's a better outcome, for sure.
And you're still in the cellar.
It's a much better outcome.
So I mean, personally, I don't think it's an option, I just.
Again, just throwing it out, and I don't think it's a viable option either, but it was something that was discussed.
You have to do it, you have to.
I had actually forgotten about it, so I apologize, I'm sure it was set up in the get-go. So are there other things we want to talk about tonight?
Can we just want to take a few minutes at the very end, to just come up maybe with a couple of questions to send up for the survey?
Oh, sure, yeah.
We can have that for our next meeting? Like I said, I'm more than happy to volunteer my volunteers to.
I think we just say, you know, the town is in the process of looking at sites for a new police department. Silver Street is one of the options, and what do we say, what are your thoughts, or?
Would you have concerns?
Yeah.
Having the police department relocate to.
Within a certain amount of yards or whatever from your residence or something of that sort, whatever it would be.
Well, what's on the location is.
Yeah, yeah.
And, you know, list your concerns or whatever, or would you be in favor, yes or no? Not, again, it's not binding you, and it's just pending approval.
And if no, why? You know, if you can share why.
And do you have other questions?
Any other concerns?
Should we say contact this group? I mean, I wouldn't want to, you know.
They could either put it in the questionnaire, or they can come to us. I mean, I think the advantage of doing it anonymously is you're probably gonna get, well, there are a lot of folks that kind of aren't afraid to certainly say what you think, trust me.
But my thought is, I don't want to go into you, because, I mean, they certainly can, but, you know, is that something else you need, or should they come to this group?
They could bring them to Caroline, drop them off there, or with the.
Well, we'll put a return envelope in there, but it'll be addressed to the select board.
Fine.
This way they'll have it, they'll have control.
Do that.
And if it's farmed out to this group or something, I'm just, don't.
Yeah.
We'll put Space Needs Committee care of Board of Selectmen.
Yeah.
All right. And half a mile either way, So I'm thinking obviously down to the section of Rollins Road, down to Cricket.
Cricket.
And then all of Silver Lane.
Yeah.
Okay, all right. What I'll do is I will put it together and I'll send it to everybody first, be to review it, make any changes or give me the thumbs up or whatever, and then we'll do that.
Now, the Silver Street lot, I saw something about the select board was having something about to bid to remove the building. Is that the building that you were referring to?
People wanted to buy it, that we've had some interest in buying just the building.
Really?
Taking it away, yeah, which will save us, when we looked into it, like close to $8,000 in demolition costs.
Yeah.
So.
So you've had some interest?
We had, but then when we sent it out, we haven't heard anything back.
Oh, okay.
People had called, I don't remember, Jody spoke to someone, she was, someone had called Town Hall, I think someone spoke to Jody directly. But then when we sent them the information, they never responded, unfortunately, so.
No, that building, is it just a top foundation, just a slab?
It's a slab.
It's not, no cellar or anything like that? Okay, okay.
It does have a drain in the middle of this, like you don't know what's underneath that drain. There may be a tank down there.
That's not holding.
No, it might just goes in the ground. Okay.
Okay.
I want to know that really.
This one was even worse.
Well, yeah, it's a different size.
You could do those things.
You want to just give me your email address?
Down to that, seep down to that little gully and then when it rains.
My little group, yep.
Eventually hit another brook.
The solution to pollution used to be dilution.
Yeah, well.
It's maybe somebody else's problem. Oh, the fishes.
Hey, great big hole, boat, and stone. It leaches down.
So here's the thing, we thought originally we'd get this done in a month, right? So we'd have a report back to the select board by June 11th, that would have.
Yeah.
It's probably not realistic, right? And that's okay, it's an artificial deadline.
Yeah.
So realistically, when do we think we could get a survey out? I'm gonna give people a couple of weeks to respond, right?
Yeah. We can get that out next week, though. Oh, give us a month anyway. Or 5 weeks to meet again.
All right.
Yeah, we should do a walkthrough of each of the sites, too.
Yeah, oh.
Bring the bug spray.
I was just.
You guys said, let's do it sooner than later.
I saw my boots in the car today.
This weekend is Mother's Day.
And it's gonna rain.
And it's gonna, a lot of rain, from what I'm hearing.
Well, maybe not now.
No, it's still Mother's Day.
Well, they said Saturday was going to be terrible.
Maybe not, or maybe oscillating south.
We want to look at maybe the 20th, a Saturday. Would that be easier for folks to go over and do it during the daytime to look?
Is it 20th Saturday?
Mm-hmm.
In the morning.
How early?
Nine, I think.
Okay.
I have a 5-year-old, so we usually up around 5 to 6 of the day. The weekend earlier, because, you know, why would you let mom and dad sleep in?
Or an evening. I mean.
Well, that's true, too.
You know, we could certainly do an evening.
Yeah, I mean, it's light out till 8 o'clock now, so.
That is very true, actually. I usually can't get home before 6, so I don't want to.
We plan to meet at, you know, Silver Street at 6:30 on Sunday.
Want to do that?
We could do that quick and then hit the other two and basically an hour, I would think, would be plenty, wouldn't it?
I had no intention of going to Turcotte's.
The 25th?
The other two.
Well, we could drive up to where it would be.
Well, you drive up where it would be.
Well, you can get a sense of where the two starting points would be to where you'd have to lay a road in.
Yeah, yeah.
The 25th, that's a Thursday. The Thursday seemed to work all right for folks, so a Thursday not usually good.
Yeah, that's fine.
So on to the 25th at 6:30, you're gonna be at on Silver Street?
Sure.
Sure, we can go from there. Down there now, so I don't forget.
Will you send?
Sure.
I can invite you all right now.
All right.
Hold on, we're not meeting at the Town Hall, we're meeting on Silver Street. Silver Street.
At 6:30?
Highway, yep. Highway, sure.
And that's the 25th Thursday?
The 25th. It's Thursday, and I don't want to break you off, but all your email addresses are right here, right? I don't remind them yet, because.
So then.
You can invite yourself.
Okay.
You would.
I have my wife on there, because I'm telling you something, I'm sorry.
No, that's okay. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna tell them that we're recommending it be surveyed. Silver?
Yep.
Okay, so that's taken care of. So what else has to be taken care of? Have to do this walkthrough.
We'll do the walkthrough, and then we'll send out the survey, so hopefully we'll have the results for the next meeting.
Yeah.
Next sit-down meeting. And hopefully I'll have some more information from either KSB Modular Company or Norman Homes. That's what Stratford.
Just for some information, Lieutenant and I actually went to Stratford PD and New Durham PD. Those are both modulars. But they didn't do it as a commercial building. They bought a house, a double white house, and just said, okay, this bedroom here is gonna be this room, and this room.
Where is it?
And.
Where is it?
New Durham and Stratford. And the biggest complaint that they have is no room. Because it wasn't designed for a police station.
Right.
They bought a double white home, and sorry, this is now your police station with an attached garage. So.
I don't know. You also don't have consistency in size rooms and all of that. I mean, you've gotta be able to design for what you need for space-wise and everything.
And all of this would be ADA, all the, you know, all the codes and everything.
Right.
When they say they want to use the heat, did they tell, they say anything to you about, you know, use the heat growing? Was it hot, first hot water?
Hot air.
Is it radiant?
Gas.
Gas fire.
Gas fire, hot air.
Hot air.
So that'd be propane, right?
Yep.
So then you gotta, well, yeah, you'd have to, because you wouldn't have a place to put your oil.
And we've actually been invited to get into this one.
So you'd have to get one of those.
I did apparently scroll the camera down, I'm gonna be in Boston that night.
That doesn't work, right?
No, so.
Propane.
Yeah.
Sorry, why don't we do, can we do the 18th, which is next Thursday, I'm sorry.
Sorry.
I didn't realize, I didn't scroll down my calendar all the way, I'm not here, so.
18th?
The 18th, yeah, I'm sorry about that.
Starting at Silver, right?
Yes. In theory, all I have to do is edit this, change the date, and all get the invoice.
And the Groen folks did mention that, you know, all their ductwork runs below the, I'll say, whatever the floor is in the attic. But above the suspended ceiling. So you have all the heat work within the heated space of the building. So you're not getting the cold air from the attic. Fighting that warm air going through the ductwork. So that's a cost savings right there, long-term energy efficiency.
And the insulation is above that ductwork.
Correct.
Yeah. Now the Milton chain, they put the heating system inside the attic.
Yep.
Up on top of the insulation.
Yeah, on top of the insulation.
And then they've had all kinds of.
All kinds of trouble.
Yes.
Sure.
Because I bet they have present time bailing somebody.
Yeah.
I talked to the guys up there, at all the PDs and the county. And they said, yeah, that was their biggest problem, they put the heating system upstairs. Why they ever did that, who the hell knows, but they did.
Wow.
We had pipes downstairs that weren't insulated, right?
Sure.
For a while, and that was causing the mold problem.
Well, is this heating system downstairs with a special design?
Special, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, sure, that's right.
So do we want to book another meeting as a follow-up meeting of the.
Of the full, once we get the.
Of the full committee again?
Sure, once we get the.
Survey back. Service the HVAC system said that it should not design that.
Yeah.
It's inadequate, same with the hot water system, it's not adequate for this building.
Johnny Garrett came over and tried to work on it.
Yeah. Shook his head and said.
Yeah, so that gives, that gives 1, 2, 3, 4 weeks.
Get responses back and compile them, so the 15th?
Yeah.
It's also a Thursday night?
Sure.
June 15th?
Yeah.
6:30 right here, in theory. All I have to do is tap my finger on this thing.
Yes.
Yeah.
phone. I don't have one of those yet. Paper works.
I prefer.
One of these days, I'm gonna get one of those. We'll see, maybe not.
Hold on as long as you can.
Right, exactly.
But it is fun.
All I see is my kids on it, you know, they're doing this while, you know, trying to have a conversation. It drives me crazy.
I love the videos there, people walking out of a building, they walked into a fountain or a pond or something.
Or the wall or a wall.
All right.
You were glad.
Same mention.
Yes.
Thank you all, thank you very much.
Yes, thank you, everybody. We appreciate that.
Let you all know.
Saturday, coffee with the chief at 10 o'clock. If, I'll have hot chocolate, but I'll have coffee there for other folks.
I wonder, I'm not gonna be in